You there. We're looking for someone in Whiterun. We'll pay good money for information. A woman, a foreigner in these lands. Redguard, like us. She is likely not using her true name. We will pay for any information regarding her location. We are not welcome here in Whiterun, so we will be in Rorikstead if you learn anything. It's none of your concern. All you need to know is that we're paying for information. If that doesn't interest you, feel free to walk away. We're looking for a fugitive who comes from Hammerfell. A Redguard woman. She may be somewhere in this city. If you locate her, find us in Rorikstead. Legion's always looking for strong, capable warriors. You think you got what it takes? Headquarters are in solid.
Nordic ruins, old, secretive. Strange to think that these chambers were once home to the ancient Nords.
Huh? Sir!
I decided I preferred clean clothes and fresh meat.
Citizen, I'm warned. Your presence is interfering with Imperial business. Be gone!
Hold it. This here's a toll road, see? You're gonna have to hand over, say, 200 gold if you want to use our road. Huh. Tough talk for someone who's about to have their guts spilled.
Wait to count out your coin. Enough of this!
Boom!
You. Tell you what, you start running so I can stab you in the back.
Hold it. This here's a toll road, see? That's a real shame. Gonna make it hard for you to pay a healer after we cave your skull in.
You can be bad. Dude! What the?
Yeah.
Yes, Sarah? If that is what you wish. Let's go. Yes, Sarah? If that is what you wish. Lead on, then.
What's a milk drinker like you doing out here?
I don't have to take that from you.
You're mine!
Yes, Sarah? If that is what you wish. Let's go. Needs, if that is what you wish. Let's go. So many shadowy corners to strike from. I could learn to like this place. Thank you.
my Ysmir. Fire, rock, like dirt.
Never should have come here.
See the battle lust in your eyes. Doom will surely come to any who cross your path.
What the?
What was that?
What the?
Traps. If you spy one, try to get an enemy to trigger it.
I'm on my way to Solitude to join the Legion. A united empire is better for everyone.
Is there something I can help you with? What's your trouble? Dostern telling tales again? Not much to it, really. We fish and keep to ourselves. Try to keep from upsetting the Empire or the Stormcloaks, and so far the war's left us alone. Until next time.
The Greybeards have summoned the Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. Such a thing has not happened for hundreds of years.
Traveler? We should swap tales sometime. I used to be an adventurer in my day. Then I settled down, got married.
I am waiting for a good death. If you are not here to grant me good death, then you leave. My time has come. I am old. Too old to become chief. It would be wrong for me to take wives at this age. So I will die. Malekith has given me a vision of a glorious death. I am to wait here until it finds me. As you can see, it has not yet arrived. Perhaps. Are you sure about this? We shall see. You're mine!
What could it mean? The return of the Dragonborn? And who among us could possibly hold that honor and such power? by the gods. It's true, isn't it? A dragon has attacked Whiterun. How could mere men bring down such a beast?
You don't look like a pilgrim. Why bother visiting Iverstead? What do you want? Klimek brings food supplies up to them once every few weeks, when the weather permits it. Other than that, they seem like a quiet lot. Don't really know too much about them. What a boring conversation.
We don't get many visitors through here. Unless they're headed up to High Hrothgar, of course. If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted. There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away. Look, I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul. Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted barrow? If you think there's anything you can do, be my guest. The Greybeards are a solitary lot. I don't think they've ever ventured outside their monastery. We get the occasional pilgrim passing through here on their way to the summit, but almost all of them have returned disappointed. I heard tell of a lad in Windhelm, Aventus Aretino. They say he's been doing the Black Sacrament, trying to contact the Dark Brotherhood. Damn fool.
Sir, I've got no interest in magic users. No use for their kind at all. They're way up north in Winterhold, and that's fine with me. I don't even like our Jarl having a court wizard.
Keep your eyes open in the barrow. That's how they get you.
You don't look like a pilgrim. Why bother visiting Iverstead?
Enemy more foul than a walking corpse.
Leave.
Strange to think that these chambers were once home to the ancient north.
Thank you.
We don't get many visitors through. Need a room? Maybe a drink?
About a year or two ago, some fella named Windelius came through. Said he was some kind of a treasure hunter. I warned him not to go in there, just like I warned you. The very next night, we heard screams from the barrow, and that was it. We never saw him again. About a year or two ago, some fella named Windelius came through.
Pardon
said
me,
he was
my lord.
Some kind of a
would you care to hear
hunter.
Me play my lute? Depends. Are you thirsty, hungry, both? A pleasant journey, my lord.
Stop by for a drink.
These damn bears are driving me crazy. This has to be the worst place in Skyrim to run a mill. How am I supposed to do anything with all those bears running around? My business is falling apart, my apprentice never listens to me, and now there's talk of dragons. If I hadn't sunk every bit of gold I had into my mill, I would have picked up and left Iverstead long ago. Are you kidding? Those damn things will drive me right out of business. Tell you what, bring me 10 of their pelts from anywhere in Skyrim. I'll gladly pay you for thinning out the herd. Now go give those stupid bears what's coming to them.
If you fancy a bit of music, let me know. Huh? I play the lute. If you'd like to hear something, it only costs 5 gold. Thank you, my lord. No lollygagging. Thank you. What do you need?
Watch the skies, traveler.
I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Hrothgar. The path isn't safe.
Aren't the Greybeards expecting some supplies?
Honestly, I'm not certain. I've yet to be allowed into the monastery. Perhaps one day. I wish I could make my deliveries more often, but the road's getting dangerous.
Hello, my friend. What can I do for you on such a fine day? I always thought it was odd that there's a layer of thick clouds covering the peak of the mountain above the monastery. Not sure what's up there, but I bet the Greybeards know. My father taught me an important lesson many years ago. He said, "Gwilym, you have the whole world before you. Go out and experience it. Be whatever you want to be." So I took his advice, and here I am. This life might not look like much to you, but I'm content. And isn't that all that matters? Have yourself a great day.
Seven 7,000 steps indeed. Next time they need to build it closer to the ground. Passing through on your way to High Hrothgar? About to make a delivery up there myself. Mostly food supplies like dried fish and salted meats. You know, things that keep fresh for a long time. The Greybeards tend not to get out much, if you catch my meaning. Well, it's kind of an understanding between us. I mean, it just wouldn't feel right to charge them for a bit of preserved food. Trouble is, my legs aren't what they used to be, and climbing the 7,000 steps takes its toll. Really? Well, that would be kind of you. Here. Take this bag of supplies. At the top of the steps, you'll see the offering chest. Just leave the bag inside, and you're done. I've been to the monastery many times, but I've never even laid eyes on one of the Greybeards. Not that I'd care to. Being masters of the Thuum, they could kill you by uttering a single word. Well, not that they would. They seem peaceful, but I wouldn't want to provoke them. Be careful up there.
We don't get many.
Need a room? Maybe a drink? Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way. Let me know if there's anything else you need.
You don't look like a pilgrim. Why bother visiting Iverstead?
Those bears are making Miss Temba so angry. I hope you can do something about them.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar. Hey, watch it!
Thank you.
I was just outside Iverstead when it happened. It's an exciting moment. Nothing like this has happened in centuries. Walking the steps, meditating on the emblems. I make this trip every few years. Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind.
So, a Dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age. First, let us see if you truly are Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice. Boom! Do not be afraid. Your shout will not harm us. Shout at us and let us taste of your voice. Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here? We are honored to welcome a Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny. That is for you to discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination. We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you. You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say. You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Roar. How the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro. Unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear. Well done. Again. quickly. Once more. Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori. See how you learn a completely new shout. Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind.
Wuld.
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thum. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of Wuld. Master Wulfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori.
X!
Wulf! Now, your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes. Quick mastery of a new thum is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself. You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jörgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ustengraf. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice, and soon your path will be made clear. Good. Then you will be ready for whatever lies ahead. He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, a master of the voice or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born. The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance. That is commendable. But remember, the dragon blood is itself a gift of Akatosh. Do not try to deny that gift. Your destiny requires you to use your voice. Why else would Akatosh have bestowed this power upon you? If you remember to use your voice in service to the purpose of Akatosh, you will remain true to the way. Five. Our leader, Partanax, lives alone on the peak of the throat of the world. When your voice can open the path, you will know you are ready to speak to him. Dragons have always been able to shout. Language is intrinsic to their very being. There is no difference in the dragon tongue between debating and fighting. Shouting comes as naturally to a dragon as breathing or speaking. In mythic times, when mortal kind was in great need, the goddess Kinnereth granted us the ability to speak as dragons do. For most people, long years of training are required to learn even the simplest shout. But for you, the dragon speech is in your blood, and you learn it almost without effort. Wind, guide you.